In the visual lecture of Histogenesis of Internal Ear, especially while talking about histogenesis of utricle and saccule, I made a gross mistake. This is what I said. So this is the structure of hair cells, and they are embedded within the supporting cells. Like this here, you can see they are embedded into the supporting cells. I hope you can understand. So this is not true, this is wrong concept. Let me tell you what it is actually like. Here it looks like that the hair cells, they are embedded into the supporting cells, but this is not true. Actually, what happens that these hair cells, they are surrounded by the supporting cells like this. For example, this is one hair cell. Here you can see this is one hair cell. It is surrounded by one supporting cell. This is one supporting cell. And here then there is another supporting cell. So it is surrounded by the supporting cells, but it is not embedded within the supporting cell. Now this is one supporting cell, and it has these lateral processes. For example, this is that lateral process, here also lateral process. So with the help of these lateral processes, and these lateral processes, by the way, they interdigitate and they have connections with each other and with the hair cells. The gap junctions are there and several different connections. Let's just not go into that, but this is the more accurate representation. It's not like that for example, if I draw a supporting cell here, if I try to draw supporting cell, it's not like that this is a single supporting cell, for example. And you may be thinking that from my previous video, you might have made the wrong concept that, for example, there is a depression within this supporting cell, and within this depression, the hair cells are lying. No, this is not true. This is the wrong concept, and I sincerely apologize for my mistake. I am thinking that you might have developed the wrong concept because of watching my video, so I decided to make a follow-up lecture to explain the accurate representation, to tell the accurate representation and diagrammatic representation of the histological picture of the hair cells and supporting cells within the macula. Now this is the situation. Rather, we can say that all of these supporting cells, they form a layer, right? All of the supporting cells, they are forming a layer, and we can say that hair cells, they are embedded into that layer of supporting cells. This would be more accurate. We cannot say that hair cells are embedded into the supporting cells. So please understand this concept, it's very important. I want every one of you to have crystal clear concept, and I do not want anyone to develop the wrong concept. Now, to understand it more clearly, we will take a section of this, and then it will become more clear. For example, let me explain it for you. For example, what I will do is that I will cut it from here. So here, let's suppose we are cutting it like this. And as we cut this section, and then you can see that what is going on inside. So if I cut it like this, let's see what is going on inside. So here is the cut section, and here in this cut section, again, you can understand that this is a hair cell, not hair cell, this is a supporting cell with the nucleus. You can see this is one supporting cell, this is other supporting cell. They are lying close to each other, and they have special connections with each other and with these hair cells as well. Don't ask me the details of these connections, that we will not talk about today, but this is the important concept. If you still have any question, or if you still have any confusion about these hair cells and supporting cells and their histology, please do comment, and I will try to make it more understandable for you. I hope it's clear now. Thank you so much for watching this follow-up mini visual lecture.